So my favorite thing about diffeq is whenever you get into it, and like even the title just sounds so intimidating, but then it'll use the word like basics. So it's like basics of second order homogeneous linear differential equations. And you're like, I have no idea what that is, but it's just the basics. It can't be that bad, right? And you're kind of right-ish, you know, it'll be fine. So basically what we're going to do is we are going to get a linear differential equation. So linear means that it has this kind of like linear-ish looking thing where we don't have anything weird going on with the y's. We don't have any y squareds. And everything that's a coefficient of some kind of a y is all in terms of x, and it doesn't have any weird y squareds. So linear just means there's no y squareds. Second order means that it's got the two little dot dots on it. Second order, it's a second differentiation. So it's like ddx and then ddx again. Now this is technically not homogeneous. Homogeneous would mean that it would equal zero. So this is just linear. So if I wanted to make it homogeneous, then I'm just going to change this f of x to zero. And now I have a homogeneous linear ordinary differential equation. Really, I should put the word ordinary in here again too, because it's not partial. Ordinary, except I can't spell because math is easy, but spelling is hard. All right, ordinary. Okay, that doesn't look right, but I think it is. Basics of second order homogeneous linear ordinary differential equations. It's not quite as straightforward as first order ordinary differential linear something equations, but we're going to start easy. So we're going to start easy, and it's always nice when you say easy and you put easy in quotes. So we'll start off by just saying, example, verify that y1 is equal to e to the x, and that y2, which is equal to e to the negative x, are solutions of this thingy, y double prime minus y equals 0. So we're just going to verify that those are solutions. Okay, so basically we're just going to verify that the first one, so we'll do this one. We've got y1 is equal to e to the x, and so that means that y1 prime is e to the x. This is a very, very complicated problem. y1 double prime still e to the x. Now we just want to make sure it's a solution of that equation thingy. So we have y1 double prime minus y prime equals 0. So we have y1 double prime, which is e to the x, minus y, which is just e to the x, and we want to know, does that equal 0? And hot doggy, it sure does. Yay, verified. All right, that was amazing. All right, let's do another one. Now we want to know y2. Is this also a solution? You're going to be like, okay. Well, so if I take the first derivative, it's negative e to the negative x. And if I take the second derivative, it's positive again, because that's how derivatives work. So if I plug this in, I've got e to the negative x minus y2, which is e to the negative x. And I want to know, is that equal to 0? And again, not shocked to find out that it is. All right, so that's kind of fun. So note that I did y equals e to the x and y equals e to the negative x. Now here's the next thing. Now we want to verify that y is equal to a, e to the x, plus b, e to the negative x, also solves that same differential equation. Y double prime minus y equals 0. So we want to prove that that also works. All right, so we've got that y is equal to a, e to the x, plus b, e to the negative x. So if you want, pause the video, see how far you can get on your own. It's really not too bad. If you're having a hard time with this, you probably need to step back and reevaluate diffeq, because this is really basic compared to what we're going to be doing. Basically, the two negatives end up canceling out again. So if I plug this in, I have y double prime minus y, minus y, which is this. And I want to know, does that equal 0? And of course, if I just do basic math, except I dropped this negative sign, but it really doesn't matter. Well, I mean, it doesn't matter in that I know what the answer is going to be. And then I go through all this, and indeed, 0 equals 0. Yay! I guess I'm going to be super awesome. I could say 0 equals 0. Okay, so I don't know if you noticed what happened, but basically what happened is I showed that if I can prove, well, I didn't really prove this, I just kind of demonstrated that, first of all, I could show that I had two separate solutions. So think about this, like, if you have a problem like x squared plus 3x plus 1, you've got two solutions, right? Because you've got the quadratic formula that's got this. So this means that no matter what, you're going to have two solutions. And you're like, well, maybe if you have something like this, you only have one solution. You're like, no. You still have x equals 3, but it has a multiplicity of 2. Because you have it twice, it hits there. Just extra hits, I guess. But we always talk about that being two roots, so it has the x equals 3 root twice. We have the same thing with differential equations, is if we have a second order ODE, we expect to have two solutions. So we have these two for the homogeneous. So we have these two solutions, and if we can find one solution and find the other one, then the full solution is actually a linear combination of those two solutions. So basically, when I say linear combination, I just mean some constant times one solution plus some other constant times the other solution. This is really, really, really important. We're going to be using this throughout Diffie Q in general. Okay, so let's go back to this. And let's do an initial value problem. So say we're going to solve the initial value problem of what we just did. So we said y double prime minus y equals 0. It seems like in this portion of Diffie Q, we spend most of our lives solving for constants. We know that this is the general form of the solution, and basically we would just want to find out what A and B stand for. Now, whenever you're solving this in ODEs, when you've got a second order, we'll say, okay, well that means that 1 is equal to A to the 0 plus E to the negative 0, so that's A plus B. And you're like, well, I know that A plus B is 1, that doesn't give me A or B. That means usually when we're using the second order, we've got to go ahead and use the second derivative. So I've got the second derivative is a e to the x minus b e to the negative x. I know y prime at 0 is equal to 3a e to the 0 plus or minus b e to the negative 0, so it's a minus b. So now I've just got kind of a simple little two equations, two unknowns kind of situation. Like that. Add them down the line. 2a equals 4. A equals 2. 2 plus b equals 1. B equals negative 1. So I can write in, I can say, okay, so that means my full solution is 2 e to the x minus b e to the negative x. So I've solved that initial value problem. So this whole idea of finding one solution, finding the other solution, this comes up a lot. So not only are we finding one solution, find the other linear combination, then we find the coefficients or the constants and kind of take it from there. So let's try this one more on your own. Well, I mean, you can just watch the video. I'm not going to stop you. Obviously, I want you to because learning is important. So I want you to verify that this cosine omega x, y1 and y2 being sine of x are solutions of y double prime plus omega squared y equals 0. So pause the video, see that you can work through this. This is a great way to practice. Make sure you know what you're doing. All right, so we'll pretend that happened. All right, so we have y1 is equal to cosine omega x, y1 prime negative omega sine omega x, y1 double prime negative omega squared cosine omega x. So if I plug in y double prime plus omega squared, and then I plug in y, does that equal 0? And you're like, yeah, 0 clearly equals 0. Yay! These are good problems to have on the test because you're like, look how smart I am. Do, 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 oops. Look how smart I am. I can't take the derivative of sine. And then you plug it in. And you get basically the exact same thing. And I'll do that one in that color so you can see what's going on. Does that equal 0? And you're like, yeah. Done. So verified. Now since we verified that both of those are solutions, then we can posit that the full solution is going to be some linear combination of those. I'm going to prove that to you in a little bit toward the end of this video, so make sure you hang on and figure that out. Now make sure that you can solve the initial value problem Again, of this same second order linear ODE, if I give you that y at 0 equals 1 and y prime at 0 equals 3. So just to build a little bit of confidence, pause the video, see how far you can get. And while you're doing that, I'm going to actually work the problem, and it's going to be amazing. Sine omega x plus b omega cosine omega x. That's the primey part. So I know that y at 0 is going to be 1. So that's a times cosine of 0 plus b times sine of 0. Cosine of 0 is 1. Sine of 0 is 0. So it means a equals 1. That one's 3. Sine of 0. Cosine 0, which is 1. So b omega equals 3. B equals 3 over omega. So I've got my full solution of y is equal to cosine omega x plus 3 over omega sine omega x. Isn't that pretty? Yay! All right, so does this always work? Can I always find one solution, find the other solution, and then it's finally a solution? And the answer is yes. So let's make sure that we understand why this is happening. Big question, why? I don't know, it makes me a sad panda. This is a panda. That's a horrible panda. They have like black eyes or something? Does that look more like a panda? I don't know, but he's sad because he doesn't know why this works. Okay, so basically what I'm gonna say is I'm going to assume, let's pretend that we have a generalized thingy, second order linear ordinary differential equation, and we know that this is true, and that y1 and y2 solve this. Now, we want to show that this, and I'll just do A1, or A, and B, is always a solution. Alright, this is my goal. Writing G's is hard. This is my goal, is I want to show that this is always a solution. Okay, so Y1 is a solution. So that means that y1 double prime plus px y1 prime plus qx y1 equals 0. y2 is the solution. So that means that y2 double prime plus px y2 prime plus qx y2 equals 0. Okay? So since I know those are true, now I want to see if this other thing is always a solution. So okay, I know, or I'm guessing, so given y is this, then let's say y prime is equal to a y1 prime plus b y2 prime, and y double prime is equal to, you guessed it, a y1 double prime plus b y2 double prime. Okay, that's amazing. So now I want to plug that in. So I have that y double prime plus px y prime plus qx y equals 0. All right, so now I'm going to plug these in accordingly. So this is going to go here, and this is going to go here, and this is going to go here. All right, so let's start off with that one. So this one. Plus px, and then this one. Oops, like that. A y1 prime plus b y2 prime, and then plus qx, and then the yellow one. I'm running out of room. I got really excited and I wrote big. Meow. I love computers. All right, and then a y1 plus b y2. And I want to know, does that equal 0? Because if it does, then I basically verified it. It's not like a fancy proof, but it's good enough. That's good enough for what I'm doing. So now I'm going to rearrange the terms. And when I rearrange these terms, I end up with a y1 double prime. So I'm going to pull all the a's out, basically, plus px ay1. Make that a big bracket. Plus qx, no a's, I just said I pulled the a's out. Y1 prime plus qx y1. And then I'm going to pull out the b. And when I pull out the b, I run out of room again. Yay! B, and then y2 double prime plus pq, or p y2 prime plus qx y2. And I want to know, is that equal to 0? And what's amazing is you might be like, but wait a second, I remember earlier I said, I'll just zoom out. Earlier I said that because I had these fancy pants solutions, I had that this here was true. So that has to be equal to 0, because those are the exact same thing. I also had this one was equal to 0, and that's the exact same thing as here. So really what I've ended up with is I've ended up with a times 0 plus b times 0. Is that equal to 0? You betcha. So that basically means we proved it. I'm going to say proved because I'm not like an official mathematician, and I always forget what is officially proving it, because I always feel like I proved stuff and then I didn't, and I feel like I didn't and I did, because proofs are weird. But basically what we've shown is if you can find two solutions to the homogeneous problem, then a linear combination of the two of them solves it as well. And now I haven't actually proved that it is the only solution. Maybe I did and I just didn't realize it. You don't really need to prove it. I don't know. If you want to find a proof, go find a proof. I didn't promise you a full proof. I promise you a quote proof. But anyway, if you can find two solutions to a homogeneous problem, second order linear ODE problem, then a linear combination of the two will solve it as well. So that's really, really cool. So pretty much throughout most of this kind of stuff, what we're going to end up doing is finding one homogeneous solution and find the other homogeneous solution and add them together and be like, look, we got an answer. So that's pretty cool.